dogs might be like. Welcome everybody to the Waste of Property meeting today. I'm Warner, welcome to Cat Property from St-Helens Council. And kind of welcome the two members of public in the gallery. Welcome everyone. Okay, so we go on to item one, which is apologies for absence. Do we have any?
Councillor Nelson.
Okay, can that be noted? So we go on to item two, which is the minutes of the authority meeting held on the 20th of November 2015. Do we have any matters arising from that meeting? Can those minutes be agreed? So we go on to item three, declaration of interest by members and officers. Not received. Not going to be noted. Item four is questions from members under Procedural Rule 9. Page 5, do we have any questions? So no questions, can that be noted as well? On item 5 is questions from members of the public under Rule 10 on page 7. Do we have any questions? Not received. So that can be noted. So item 6, motion proposed by members under Rule 15. Not received. So we go on to item 7, which is the annual meeting and timetable meeting for 16-17, and that's on page 11. Amanda, you're going to take us through that report?
Thank you, Chair. I'll keep this rather brief. Every year this time of in February, we ask members to set the date of the annual meeting. We're required to set that date before the 30th of June, and we normally make sure that it's after the AGMs of our constituent district councils. We're proposing this year to have the AGM on Friday the 24th of June. And then on page 14 there's a schedule of meetings for the rest of the year, so we're just asking members to approve that schedule of dates.
Any questions or observations on that before?
Actually, I just want the two that were said needed to be 2 o'clock, is that right?
It's the availability of the authority chain, so there are meetings already scheduled that we wouldn't have the room.
Okay. No more questions. Can you agree that report? Okay, so we go on to item 8, internal audit financial systems, on page 17. And Peter, you're going to take us start with that and then Catherine will take us through. Thank you, Peter.
Thanks, Chair. Once again, we've to remind members, our internal audit at the authority is provided by St-Helens Council. CAP from St-Helens Council has come along to reflect their views of the report. My own comment on the report is that it's a review of the financial systems that we buy and research on the agreement from St-Helens Council. CAP's people have made a couple of recommendations, but those have been completely accepted by the authority officers. And once again, it's a high assurance from CAP's team. On that note, I'll hand you over to CAP.
To item 9 on page 33, which is the Treasury Management Strategy Statement for 16-17, Annual Revenue Provision Policy Statement, Annual Investment Strategy, and Treasury Management and Prudential Indicators. And Peter, you're going to take us through that one?
I promise I'll be as brief as I can. Before I start, can I draw attention to a title on page 40, where there should be a heading in the column, which each of the columns, which says pounds, thousands, not pounds, millions, because otherwise we're dealing with figures that are billions. Actually, we're dealing with figures that are pounds, thousands, and millions. So I apologise for that. The report covers the authority's overall approach to revenue provision, annual investment strategy and prudential indicators. It's supported, as the fair brief report, supported by a more detailed appendix, which covers the issues that members are asked to consider in some detail. To provide context, at the time of writing, the authority had a portfolio of over £17 million worth of loans outstanding, and the temporary surplus funds are invested through Cllr's council with service level agreements. So it's a complex position. The current treasury position is covered in the report on pages 39 to 46. It provides a snapshot for members of the extent of the authority's existing borrowing, together with the average rates of interest being paid, and the length of time over which the authority has borrowed money. And the table on pages 40 and 41 also confirms that the authority's borrowing remains within its borrowing limits. When we're not immediately using the funds to pay running costs, the funds are invested using St-Helens Council's treasury management under the service level agreement. And that ensures the safety of funds and the best return available. We don't go for very high returns because we don't want to take risk with public money. And that's been a policy that we've signed up to with St-Helens for some time. The picture on page 44 gives a snapshot of what those investments are and the type of organisation we invest with and the credit status of that organisation. And we tend to invest, well, St-Helens on our behalf tends to invest in fairly high, highly secure organisations. On our part, with the prospect of continuing reductions in the surplus funds that we may have available, the prospect that interest rates are continuing to remain low, we don't anticipate the investment of our surplus funds to generate significant amounts of income going forward as they have done in the past. You'll also see on pages 41 to 57 a version of an economic outlook that's provided to us by Capita, who are the treasury management advisors, which confirms once again the uncertainty in the world and the likely interest rates uncertainty going forward, which means it's not going to be going up very quickly. We're not planning to take out any further borrowing at this stage, and we're not planning to try and transfer any of our existing borrowing into the even lower rate because we've already got fairly low cost borrowing, and the premium that you pay to transfer from one loan to another, it makes it not worth it. The annual revenue provision strategy on page 52 and 53 confirms for members the approach to statutory set aside that local authorities are required to make, which ensures there are sufficient funds available when repayments become due. The general authority policy has been to date and continues to be recommended that this set aside is spread over the life of the asset against which the original borrowing was made. In future, we may come forward with a report that asks members if they want to change that approach, because a number of authorities are changing that approach and are setting aside smaller amounts to save on revenue. The annual investment strategy on page 53 has been adopted to follow the St-Helens Council strategy by not investing in risk account parties and protecting funds and seeking the best return thereafter. My view would be that the authority should be recommended to follow this relatively low risk approach. And finally, the authority's treasury management and prudential indicators are set out in pages 65 and 66. They both establish the limits over the authority's borrowing and are used to report on and confirm that the authority does not exceed those limits. Were there ever to be any danger of exceeding those limits, a report would be prepared for members on the issues and risks that were being faced at the time, and members would have an opportunity to stop from going beyond those limits if they wanted to at that point. I think that's sufficient on that report from me.
Thanks, Peter. Any questions or observations? Colleagues, comprehensive report given details. So the recommendations are on page 53. Can we agree then? Is that agreed? Thank you. Colleagues, before we go on to item 10 for the budget for 2016-17, have a 20-minute adjournment. Can that be agreed? Some further information to be considered. Thank you very much for that. We've got 20 minutes.